Hello friends, today we will see the two most important error correction techniques okay, from the information theory and source coding. Already we have started the linear block code. In the linear block code, we are having the two most important error correction techniques. Already we have discussed about which are the error correcting techniques and which are the error detection techniques. In that we have seen the functions, depending upon the function we are having the two error correction techniques, depending upon the parameter we are having the two error correction techniques. Now the remaining last two error correction techniques which are very much important in the linear block code, as we have seen that the two more important error correction techniques are nothing but forward error correction technique. Among that, first it is a forward error correction technique. Forward error correction, it is called as FEC. FEC is nothing but a forward error correction. Okay. As its name indicates, it is forwarded for the error correction in the receiver, towards the receiver. That's why it is called as the forward error correction. And the second type is resend, to resend the error correction. It is nothing but a ARQ technique, automatic request for retransmission. Automatic request. For retransmission. That is called ARQ. Okay, these are the two most important error correction techniques, forward error correction and the automatic request for retransmission from the receiver to the destination. We can send the request. It is called as the automatic request for retransmission. That's when we say that these are the error correction techniques, forward error correction versus the automatic request for the retransmission. Now we will see in detail what is the ARQ and what is the FEC, forward error correction. So first we will see what is ARQ, automatic request. Okay, this is the second type we consider as one. In that, for the automatic request for retransmission, we are having the definition for that. In the ARQ system, the receiver can request towards the transmitter for the retransmission of message or the part of message which is not correct. Okay, that's why whatever the total message is there, if they are in the receiver, they have found that there is a correction in the message, at that time that message totally or the part of the error which is having the error, that particular part to resend the retransmission of the data, the receiver can be given. And for that we require a channel. That is called as the feedback channel. Through a feedback channel, the receiver, that means we are having, this is the sender or the transmitter, this is the channel, this is the receiver, and receiver which gives the retransmission message, and it is called as the feedback. Through this receiver can give the message towards the transmitter to resend the data or the message. Okay, this is nothing but the feedback part. In this, we require a feedback part to transmit the data, to retransmission of the data towards the receiver. That means in this, we require a very much important part. We have to remember that there is a retransmission of the message or the part of message through a feedback channel. We can retransmit. That is called as the automatic request for retransmission. Okay. In that, we require a feedback channel. Now, the second part, it is nothing but a, which is your second part? It is nothing but a forward error correction. It is called as the forward error correction. It is the method. By using that, we can find out the error. Forward error correction. It is called as the FEC. FEC. F stands for forward, E stands for error, and C stands for the correction. FEC. Forward error correction. In the forward error correction, there is a no need of feedback channel. No need of feedback channel, because whatever the error occurred in the receiver, if receiver detects that error, okay, whatever the receiver comes the data from the destination, when receiver find out some error is there, at that time in the transmission media, this receiver said that is whatever the given error is there, it is forwarded towards the receiver. That's why it is called as the forward error correction. In the forward error correction technique, there is no such feedback path and request for retransmission. So, error correction has to take place at the receiver. That means whatever the error correction is there, it is taken place at the receiver. Okay, that's why if transmitter or in the transmission media, they have found that there is a loss of data or there is a error in the data, at that time whatever the given message given forwarded towards the receiver as it is, because there is no any feedback path. That's why whatever the error correction is there, that should be take place at the receiver. That is called as the forward error correction. These are the two most important error correction technique from the linear block code. Okay. Now, we will see regarding the structure of the linear block code. The code word structure for the linear block codes. Linear block code. In the linear block codes, we are having the code word structure. In that code word structure, we are having some message bits, that is nothing but a K message bits, and the parity bits with the K message bits. And the total code word structure, whatever the code word is there, that is called as the N message bits. Okay. So the code word structure, it will be like this. That is called as the message bits or the data bits up to this. And whatever the remaining part, it is nothing but a parity bits. Parity bits. And these parity bits are nothing but a redundant bits. Redundant bits. Okay. These are nothing but a K message bits and parity bits. And the total code word structure, it is nothing but a N message bits. N, it is combination of the K as well as the parity bits. That's why that is called as the K message bits, K and N minus K. K and N minus K bits. Okay. Now we'll see the generation source encoder, and then it is given to the destination. We are having a source then encoder is there, encoder, and when there is an encoding process is there, encoding, it is nothing but the generation of this code block. It is called as the code word structure of the given message. Okay, whatever the k message bits are all coming from the source, and this source given to the encoder. Encoder now get from the source as a k message bits. The encoding, for the encoding purpose, this encoder will restructure that k message bit in the code word as n form, having the k and the n minus k code word structure. That is nothing but the linear block code, code word structure for the linear block code. Now the code word structure with respect to the k message bits, we will see the code word structure for this. We are having the k message bits, and here we are having a parity bits. Parity bits also called as the redundant bits. These are nothing but for the protection purpose. These are not the given total message bits. M0 to mk minus 1. M0, m1, m2 up to the mk minus 1. And this is nothing but a n message bits. And this is called as the code word structure. Code word structure. And the parity bits are nothing but B0, B1 to the Bn minus K minus 1. B0, B1 to the Bn minus K minus 1. These are nothing but the parity bits or the redundant bits. Redundant bits. These redundant bits are nothing but with the message bits, they are having the encoded bits. Whatever the given original message information from the sender to the receiver, it is nothing but only these k message bits. This is the code word structure. This is the code word structure. Code word structure of the linear block code. By using this linear block code, we can find out the code word structure with the M0, M1 up to the, that's why we are having the matrix representation for this as matrix representation for, by using this code word structure is nothing but a X is equal to MB, capital M and B. This is the matrix structure where we are having m is equal to k message bits and the b, it is nothing but n minus k parity bits. This is the matrix representation of the linear block. Okay, so the generator matrix representation of the linear blocks we can find out. We will find out the matrix representation for the linear block. Now we will see the matrix representation of linear block codes. Matrix representation. Matrix representation. In the matrix representation, we are having matrices are used for obtaining the code words. The generation of code words in the matrix form is as follows. As X is nothing but a, having the matrix, X is nothing but a 1 into n. that is a matrix representation 1 into n is equal to mg is equal to m and g. With the m, we are having the notations 1 into k and k into n. 1 into k and k into n. We are having a matrix for this linear block force as x is equal to m into j. X where we are having x 1 into n, m 1 into k and g. Now we will see what exactly the meaning of matrix X, matrix M and the matrix G. For this we are having Kolber matrix of 1 into n side. Kolber matrix of 1 into n signs. This is the total Kolber matrix X is equal to with the size of 1 into n. This capital M denotes the message word matrix of 1 into k size. Message word matrix of 1 into k, size of this 1 into k size. And this generator G, it is nothing but a generator matrix of k into n size. Generator matrix of size, what is size here? K into n size. This is nothing but a linear block code which is having the matrix representation. The matrix representation here, we are having the matrix for the linear block code X having the size 1 into n is equal to m into g. This X, it is nothing but the total Kolber matrix with the size 1 into n. Then m, it is nothing but a message word matrix of size 1 into k, and the g, it is nothing but a generator matrix of size k into n size. Okay. By using this matrix representation, we can solve the matrices for different numericals. By using that, we can find out the generator matrix for the linear block. Okay. Now we will see the generator matrix, the structure of the generator matrix. By using this, we can find out the error correction by the linear block. Okay, see here. Now we will see the generator matrix. What is the generator matrix? In this generator matrix, G is equal to in matrix I, K with the P having the size K into N size. Now here I, K is nothing but a K into K identity matrix. I, K is nothing but a identity matrix with the size K. And the P, it is nothing but a K, N minus K, whatever the total parity bits is there. P, it is nothing but for the parity matrix, we are having the size of K, N minus K, coefficient matrix. So, we can represent the identity matrix IK in this way, 1, 0, up to the 0. Then 0, 1, dash, dash, up to the 0, to the 1. That's why 1 and 1. K into K, and the P for the parity matrix, it is the coefficient matrix with the P 0 0, P 1 0 up to the 0. Then P 0 1, P 0 K minus 1 with the size of K into N minus K. N minus K is nothing but whatever the parity bits are there, redundant bits are there. That's why it is the generator matrix. Now we can represent the linear block code by using the generator matrix, and the identity matrix is nothing but X is equal to MG. Okay, this is the matrix for the linear block code with the message bits and the generator matrix. Now, in the next lecture, we will see some numericals by using the linear block code with the generator matrix and the matrix with the LBC. So, today we will stop here.